part one of the Hidden History of Humanity documentary, we covered an introduction to the grander scheme of cosmos and the enormous cycles of the Manvantaras that circulate through the chains and globes of our Earth scheme. This involved the consideration of the Hindu Yugas and astronomical precession cycles, plus the cyclical nature of time, all inextricably linked with the unfoldment of the root races, subraces, and nations. In short, the history of civilization. We examined the idea of human individualization in ancient Lemuria and the implantation of the spark of mind that started the evolution of consciousness throughout the root races. This period of planetary history encompasses the profound mystery of the origin of the human soul. The nature of the planetary center we call Shambhala was explored, plus those who guide humanity, the Lords of the Flame, the Mighty Ones, and the Masters of Wisdom. Two of the Hidden History of Humanity documentary, we will review the original Shambhala as the Temple of Ibez, located in South America. Also, the evolution of the Atlantean root race, giants, megalithic constructions, and the Great Atlantean War, as told in the ancient epic, the Mahabharata. We will detail how the two great world wars of the last century were a recapitulation of the war in Atlantis, a conflict between the forces of light and the forces of materialism, still ongoing today. Plato's Atlantis is also mentioned as an important source of the ageless wisdom. This will lead us to the consideration of the role of the Egyptian and Mayan traditions and their relevance in modern times, leading into the coming sixth root race. We will explore the importance of Britain, the United States, and Brazil as a triangle of nations preparing us for the sixth root race, imminent Earth changes and cataclysms, the year 2025, and the reappearance among humanity of the Masters of Wisdom for the first time since those ancient Atlantean days. All these changes will be occurring on the eve of the Aquarian cycle, where spiritual initiation will be achieved en masse, and the expansion of human consciousness will go steadily forward. This period of awakening is upon a higher turn of the evolutionary spiral to humanity's individualization, which occurred in ancient Lemuria when the planetary center known as Shambhala was established. It is highly likely that this original Shambhala outpost could have been in Brazil or the region of Lake Titicaca, straddling Peru and Bolivia. In these early Lemurian times, human bodies were gigantic and clumsy, requiring instruction in what we now call Hatha Yoga, in order to coordinate the etheric body with the physical. This was the first spiritual goal for humanity and represented the first initiation.
In order to prepare suitable candidates for initiation, it was decided about 17 million years ago to build an organization and a headquarters for the mysteries, and to have a band of adepts and celestial guides who would function in physical bodies to meet the need of the rapidly awakening humanity. These beings incarnated as key kings and priests of nations, the instructors of humanity. The Ibizan adepts had to deal with the humanity that was in its infancy, whose polarization was most unstable, and whose coordination was very imperfect. There was very little mentality to be found as we know it today, and humans were practically altogether astral in their expression. They functioned even more consciously on the astral plane than on the physical. And it was part of the work of the guides of the race, working under instruction from Shambhala, to develop the energy centers of humans, to stimulate the brain, and make them fully self-conscious on the physical plane.
Infant humanity of Lemurian and early Atlantean days had to be taught who they were by means of symbols and methods, which to us would be crude, impossible, and of a nature which the race should have transcended many millions of years ago. It was necessary in those days to employ methods more definitely physical than are permissible today. These methods of physical stimulation were employed, and the laws of energy, as they work through the various chakras, were taught until the time came when another big change was made and the door of initiation was opened. Their objective was to bring about a realization of the kingdom of God within. It was felt at the time that man was then self-centered enough and individualized enough to permit of a drastic change in method and practice.
Why have the Mayans come to assume such prominence in popular thought in the past 50 years? We have been told that there will be an alignment with the galactic center. Yet is the end and beginning of two 26,000-year precession cycles. This will be taking place in Aquarius on the Great Wheel, coinciding with the more well-known 2,160-year cycle in Aquarius on the Lesser Wheel.
Hence, we are in a time of unique opportunity. Two Aquarian cycles. A new precession cycle will take humanity into the sixth root race proper in about 25,000 years' time. But Mayan elders and others connected to the secret wisdom do acknowledge that Earth changes will increase for the next few hundred years, and it is occurring with increasing frequency now. Humanity regards these kind of events as material disasters, yet they have always been cyclic in nature and accompany the shift of consciousness from one race to another, just as there is usually a new continent that is raised for the new race. Hence, parts of South America may sink, whilst other older landforms nearby may be raised out of the sea. The Mayan tradition points the way to South America and its role for a reawakened Shambhala, from where the Ancient of Days, or the Lord of the World, will resume his watch for the sixth root race. The Mayans' ancient base in Guatemala and the consciousness that was generated there is a bridge between North America with its synthesized European consciousness and the future sixth root race in South America. For thousands of years, Central America has played the role of a great meeting place for many cultures from the Pacific and the Atlantic Oceans. Currently, the main focus for Shambhala is in one of its branches somewhere in the Gobi Desert in Mongolia, existing in invisible etheric matter. As noted earlier, the original location of Shambhala in Lemurian times was in South America, whilst another branch of Shambhala was much later connected to the Mayans in Guatemala. Hence, a full circle cycle approaches, where the focus of this planetary crown chakra we call Shambhala will shift to South America once more. Occult lore states that during this period, Britain will sink entirely, whilst a large chunk of California will disappear.
Cataclysms will occur worldwide during the next 1,000 years. Continents will be shaken. Lands will be raised and submerged, culminating in the profound material disaster, which will overtake the world towards the close of the fifth root race. This will usher in the infant sixth root race. Yet all of these events happen within naturally occurring cycles. The elevation and subsidence of continents is always in progress. The whole coast of South America has been raised up 10 to 15 feet. The British Islands have been four times sunk beneath the ocean and subsequently raised again and peopled. Within the last 5,000 or 6,000 years, the shores of Sweden, Denmark, and Norway have risen from 200 to 600 feet. In Scotland, there are raised beaches with outlying stacks and skerries surmounting the shore, now eroded by waves. The north of Europe is still rising from the sea, and South America presents the phenomenon of raised beaches of over 1,000 miles in length, now at a height varying from 100 to 1,300 feet above sea level.
Forms, whether they are land masses or humans, come and go. But the consciousness remains and moves forward. It is the soul's evolution toward liberation that is the most important factor, whether it be individual, group, racial, national, or global. The sixth root race is where the intuition will be developed and will express itself through the qualities of the heart and right human relationships. Humanity will reclaim knowledge of some of the lost Atlantean technologies, create new forms of music and art, as well as gain an understanding of the nature of the soul, reincarnation, and its true place in history. The Aquarian cycle will be an age of science, exoteric and esoteric, where the universal spiritual laws will come into a much closer alignment with our earthly laws, and a period of peace could well reign in the new Satya Yuga or Golden Age. The sixth subrace represents a synthesis of all Western and Eastern races, particularly in the USA. Note in the triangle diagram that one common denominator is the energy of the second ray of love wisdom, as the soul ray of Britain and the USA, and the personality ray of Brazil. In the coming race, it will not only be the intuition or Buddhic consciousness that will be the evolutionary goal, but the expression of the loving heart. The nature of the soul is relationship, and the challenge for humanity is to demonstrate right human relations. It is one of the keys of the imminent Aquarian cycle.
As stated in the beginning of this documentary, this first series of the hidden history of humanity is meant to establish a broad structure of understanding. A future series will follow and fill in more detail. In the meantime, The viewer can visit the author's website or obtain various publications such as The Hidden History of Humanity, Volume 1, or The Shambhala Impacts.
Discovering and understanding the origin of the human soul and its divine pedigree is imminent in our time. We stand before a doorway leading to planetary illumination upon the greatest mysteries of life, the hidden history of humanity.